Good morning, everybody. Welcome back to Thief Gold. Today's mission is Song of the Caverns. If you're playing Thief Dark Project, you don't get to play this one. You'll just have to skip it. Here's my save from the end of the Lost City. As always, the briefing cinematic has been separately uploaded to the playlist. You can view it there at your leisure. Let's look over our objectives. Locate your informant, Geary. He may have valuable information about the caverns for you. Use the Keeper's map to find the Talisman of Water. Remember, they've probably rigged the place, so be careful. Escape from the caverns after you've taken the Talisman. It may not be as easy as you think. Loot may be scarce down in the caverns, but an expert thief such as yourself should be able to find at least 200 worth. Humans will be as scarce in the caverns as loot, so if you find your informant Geary or any people, don't kill them. Much like assassins, our objectives will be changing pretty quickly, but not nearly as rapidly as they did there. I happen to really like Song of the Caverns. I like the tone of the mission. I like the shift that it undergoes from the outset to becoming a standard human mission, and of all the standard human guard sort of missions, I think in many ways it's the most creative. I like the ribbing of artistic types that goes on in the opera house. Anyway, let's get started. As always, no purchases are needed, but I will warn you to be careful when you hit play mission, because you start out in sight of a guard, so if you start moving too fast, you can get a first alert from him right away, and obviously, we don't want that. You see him up in the tower. Let's look at our map. We start out at the entrance, moving through the caverns, we come to some spiders. Beware, brethren, one man lost. Past the spiders, we reach an abysmal cavern swim. Next, we'll run into some craymen, four men lost. 3 weeks did we toil to make the shrine, and once we reach the shrine, keeper brethren, stand not against us, lest you feel the sting of ignorance's barbs. Sadly, one more did we lose on our return. We don't know what's past the shrine. So, initially, I'll point out that the archer has a pickpocket that we want. The first of 13 in this mission. So, if you just carefully move... Oh, I was on steps. I didn't even know that. To this area here, you should be safe from comments from him.
I don't see why I should have to be the one down here in the cold and the dark and the damp.
I do want to get his key. I always go after pickpockets. You should know that by now. We're going to need 2 crates to get to him. So I got one right here. No, there's some others. There they are. This mission has a lot of really complicated parts if you're going to perfect thief it, but I'm sure you'll be glad to know that it is fully possible to perfect thief it. Oops. Do I already have one crate in there? No. Alright, let's use these two. I think I figured out what I need to do now. All right.
Who died here?
It's important to drop it straight down. Which Garrett doesn't often like to do. There we go. That's one, and that's two. Perfect. You'll know you're actually on because Garrett will be able to crouch. Now we can hop onto this roof here, and we can hop over to here. So far, we're completely free from even first alerts. Let's just grab his key. That's all I need out of here. One pickpocket, and now we're gonna drop it as close to him as we can. That's too close.
Who died here?
That's also too close.
Who died here?
Even that's too close. There we go. Now, if you're interested, inside the tower there are also, I believe, six moss arrows. Six broadhead arrows. I don't care about that. Hold on, my run controls are messed up. Saving and reloading usually solves that problem. Well, but it can create entirely new ones if you're not careful. There's a moss arrow out here, if you're interested in that. So, let's just get back down to the ground the way we came, mostly. Put the crates back where we found them. Alright, that's one out of 13 pickpockets before we even move into the sewer system. Just slide into here. Don't move too far forward or the archer can still spot you from the tower. Be nice and quiet too, at least until you get the door shut behind you. I don't really feel safe until I shut this door behind me, too. Because then, you'll notice, we're on a stone floor. Now we're far enough away from everyone to avoid any alerts, so dive into here. And we'll move right along. We hear some spiders, and they are almost as horrific as the ones in the Lost City were. This is going to be one of the hardest parts of ghosting this mission, but it is possible.
Guess I'm not getting any information from Geary.
It's hard to even get to Geary without alerting the spiders, as you can hear.
Guess I'm not getting any information from Geary after all.
You'll notice Geary's got a healing potion, if you're interested. Let's read his journal, at least. Come on, Garrett. Oh, it doesn't like me holding the lean key. More spiders arrive today. That makes 12 this week. I have no time to puzzle over this strange migration. I must pack up my belongings and move elsewhere on the morrow. Geary. So, there are two spiders down there. Through circumstances beyond our control, one of them is already about to die. You see the stationary one? His idle turning in the in a span of about 5 minutes.
Guess I'm not getting any information from Geary after all.
We'll slide him all the way down into the water where he'll drown. Let's look at our objective screen. We got our Geary objective ticked off, unfortunately for him. So you see the very short patrol being walked by that spider. You see the mushrooms, which we can't do anything about, even playing normal ghost. You're going to be completely illuminated the entire second half of the tunnel. And with the moving spider, he will rapidly become our only concern. We will have a window of, I don't know, something like 2.5 seconds to get all the way down the tunnel silently into the water and out of his sight without busting our ghost. It is possible, but extremely difficult. So, the first thing we're going to do is wait for the stationary spider to go ahead and finish committing suicide. Usually takes about 5 minutes once you get close enough for him to start turning. We can go ahead and move a little bit though. We want to very quietly, very slowly creep as low as we possibly can before we get illuminated by that mushroom. How far can we go, you ask? The answer is not very far. Take a quick save for every little step here. Try to stay flush with the left side of the tunnel. Eventually we'll get a first alert chirp, and we'll know that's as low as we can go while staying undetected. As always, the stationary spider sees with his butt, which is helpful. Alright, I have to say, I really feel like he should have chittered by now, but maybe I'm wrong. Now you see how rapidly the stationary spider ended up down there. He's dead. Before we could even finish creeping down the tunnel. So, that's not a bust, because there's no way I can stop that from happening. So, the spider deciding to kill himself really isn't my fault. Anyway, this is about as low as we're going to get, so I'm going to make a secondary reel save here, just in case. And what we have to do is jump into the water without making noise after sprinting all the way down the tunnel. Then we have to get out of his line of sight, all without triggering a search mode alert, which is, you know, crazy. Aye, aye, aye. You'll see, though, that the spider always turns left. So we're going to have to use that to our advantage. Let's go ahead and do this. This, I get the feeling, is a part where I'm going to have to annotate the video and tell you how long it takes me to successfully make the move. Here's our first try. Yeah, no dice. So he's in search mode now because I made a splash. Oh, pfft. That wasn't that bad at all. Didn't even get a first alert. There I was all worried. Good grief. Of course, we aren't done with him exactly, but... we're in a much better position already. So we also need to get into this deeper water without getting spotted. That shouldn't be that tough. Well, maybe it will be. I gotta figure out a way to do it without making noise. That's the main thing. Can't have that splash, Garrett. Perfect. Later, dude. Finally, just keep moving slowly here because he can still hear you splashing. So we're past the spiders and we have arrived at the abysmal cavern swim. The keepers seem a little hyperbolic about the actually pretty brief journey through the caverns, because it's really not that bad, and the caverns are pretty small, all things considered. You can see the water arrow down that tunnel. Anyway, let's swim through it. Got my bearings now. Alright. I'm moving into here. There are a total of 4 Craymen in this area. We'll have to be careful of. Only 1 patrols, if I remember right. I don't want that first alert chirp if I can help it. I hear the patroller coming this way, so let's back out here for the moment. Plenty of shadows in here, which is good. There's our patroller. Let's follow him down this tunnel. None of these water holes really go anywhere of their own accord. They're just ways to sneak through this particular subset of caverns into some other water holes. We want to sneak behind this guy. It seems the key to avoiding an alert is not to move too fast. Which I keep doing. If it weren't for this little lip, it wouldn't be so bad, but that alone makes it pretty difficult to get in here. Hope we're shadowed enough. We're not. Probably have to accept the first alert there. Which, you know, I'm fine with. Can't supreme this mission anyway, so... I'll take that first alert hit. No problem. There's another patrolling Cray man here. So this little bit of water is our way out. Just be careful that they're far enough away that they don't start hunting for you. I hear no search mode. So. In we go. Head up here. Oh, come on. There's a breath potion if you want it. I fear to go on. The rest of the expedition have gone on ahead, and I was to follow directly. But when the last of them disappeared beneath the surface of the water, all my strength and courage disappeared with them. When they see that I do not follow, they will surely send someone back for me. I need only wait a moment more, or perhaps at most an hour. Dark thoughts haunt me. What is time in a place that sees no sun or moon? What good are tears in a place that is all water? I must rest now. Oh, to have a spot dry enough to recline upon comfortably. That's kind of grim and morbid, but there you go. Alright. Do another real save past all the Cray men. We are past them, whether the map indicates that for us or not. Here's a handy air pocket for us to use. Head up here first. Now that we've got our air, let's go get our first piece of loot. If Garrett will swim down. There we go. Hear the idle chitters of another Cray man. Can't surface there, obviously. I got a little disoriented. Come on, Garrett. There you go. So move to the pool. Make sure you swim to the other side. And then surface here. And he shouldn't do more than first alert. Which is good. All right. Nab the silver nugget here. That's worth 50. Brings our total to 50. Hear some funky singing. And if you hadn't already, maybe begin to figure out where this mission is actually headed. So now, duck back under. Head into the upper cave where we just got some air earlier. Come on, come on, come on. Be careful of your noise level. I should have started being careful sooner, but what can you do? Not much. It's okay, he never went search mode. Alright, let's save here. Because we have reached the shrine. All right. So, we need to get in behind him while he's turned that way. That's phase one. He faces up the stairs, and he also turns left. And when he's facing left, we need to get up these stairs. And that didn't work out, but you'll notice there's a shadow up at the top. He needs to face that way long enough for us to get to it. SOB. Let's try moving faster. Well, see, he likes to face up the stairs. Seems to have a preference for it. Good, we made it with only a first alert. That's what we're after. If we wait for him to turn again, we can just creep over before he turns back. And we're set. Very good, very good. Let's read this. Stand not against us, lest you feel the sting of ignorance's barbs. Now the entire room is trapped, so just stay crouched, you'll be fine. These are supreme busts too, but let's read this pamphlet. To Captain Collyard from Lady Valerius, I have received word of the shrine and treasure room you have found during your mission to eradicate our little spider problem. I look forward to receiving whatever bounty lies there, and will not tolerate any more excuses about mysterious traps or other dangers. Success, Lady V. Oh, but we have to be careful about the traps, because they will cause the Crayman to come searching for us. Anyway, you can get the two arrows out of his body if you're interested. I wonder if there's a way through the room that doesn't trigger the traps. There might be. Let me try this. Excellent. So, now let's approach the chest.
Empty. Now what?
I wanted to get that little comment from Garrett. Okay. Be careful not to trip that trap. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Obviously, we have to stay out of the center of the room. I just like to... Okay. No way to get to the pamphlet without triggering the trap, unfortunately. That was just another first alert. So, let's move on. Ah, the singing. The singing is fun. And here is the source. We're gonna have to listen.
I spy you, little fish. Oh no, it's a big fish, rather. Are you here to sing too? We'll reenact the memorable scene between Raoul and Valerius at the bridge. I'll begin. The city at night. Raoul, the handsome young opera house owner, sings to the Lady Valerius. I, Raoul, do accuse you of using treachery to obtain your wealth. Then Lady Valerius sings. I, Lady Valerius, have obtained the opera house, yes. Right from under your nose, you must kiss the ground underneath my toes. Now, I live here, under the opera, but I go back, stealing food and such as I need. She can't kick me out, not Raoul. Then they come down, looking for spiders, but they found the treasure from the shrine instead. Now, she has that, too. I've seen her with it. It has powers. You could steal it from her, yes. That would make her sad. Let's see. What would she sing? Ah, I know.
Lady Valeris, weeping in her chamber, sings,
I, Lady Valeris, am so, so sad. Where has the treasure gone that once made me glad?
You need a map. Raoul has a map. You need a key. You can get that too from me. Remember,
a left at the sewer. To the right might look newer. That's the secret of the way in. Now go, go, go. Up, up the rope you go. Why do you move so slow? Let us reenact the memorable scene again between Raoul and Valerius at the bridge. I'll begin.
I am telling a terrible story, but it doesn't diminish my glory, for they would have taken my daughters over the... I can't remember the rest of the words. It's been so long now, but I had such glory, such fame.
We are going to need that key. Let's look at his map and then drop the papyrus. So here's our map of the Opera House. We've got a very detailed map, which is good, and although in his ranting he neglected to tell us this, the red X's mark secret passages to various places. So here in the basement there's a bathroom, kitchens, wine cellar, pretty straightforward. Good detailed map of the interior though, which is always nice. On the first floor, a couple of secret passages, a guard station, we know where the ticket office is. The second floor, we've got a couple more secret passages. Cribs, we don't know what that is, but we'll find out. He's the director of the operas. And here on the third floor, we got a couple more secret passages. We got the library, and V is Lady Valerius.
Oh, you won't.
Let's leave the map.
Hit those low notes, will you? No, not him ever.
So, hop up the rope. On top of Raoul's little house here, there are a couple of moss arrows if you want them.
The curtains went down on this guy a long time ago. He's the best lead I have.
All right, let's get far enough away from him that you can hear me talking. And let's look at our new objectives. Find and steal the Talisman of Water. The strange hermit's ravings are your best clue that the talisman has been moved to the opera house above the caverns. Find the opera house and break in. The opera house is filled with precious adornments and attracts the city's wealthiest patrons, so don't leave without at least 2,000 worth of loot. When he was alive, your informant Geary often bragged about the cash take in just a single evening at the opera house. Find out if he was telling the truth, get to the ticket office, and steal the contents of the cash box. You read last week that the music director at the opera house was just presented with a silver flute. An item like that could fetch a pretty penny on the market. Find it. Littering the opera house with blood and corpses is not worthy of a master thief such as yourself, so pickpocket, rob, steal, hide, and even run if you have to, but don't kill anyone. After you get what you came for, get to the city streets outside the opera house. I wonder if dropping the papyrus we get to keep the good map. Ah, yes we do, good. So, now that we're down in the sewer, we'll remember what Raoul said. Turning right will take us out to the city streets in front of the opera house, which is actually a pretty viable exit from the mission and the one we'll end up taking. Let's read this scroll. Mr. Colliard, it is not enough to kill the spiders brazen enough to enter the basement. You must tell your men to descend into the sewers and below. They must kill every spider they see. They must search until no more spiders are found. It does not concern me if men are lost or if they are afraid to venture past the sewers into the tunnels beyond. If your men cannot complete this simple task, I will find men more suitable to the work. And are you so sure you can get other work without a recommendation from the opera? I think not. Report to me on the morrow regarding your progress. L. Valerius. So Valerius is an evil biznitch. We don't feel bad stealing from her at all. As we turn left, we arrive in the basement of the opera house.
This looks like the way in.
All right. Let's get started. First things first, I'll point this out to you. Thankfully, I don't have to mess with it because it's a huge pain for ghosting. But if we track this fellow's patrol, The room he's about to turn into looks like the warm-up room for the dancers or some such. It's a pain to cross, it's full of people, but inside the room you can find a healing potion and a cheese inside the chests, all of which are pretty useless. As you move this direction, instead, the ambient sound in the opera house is terrific, by the way. Another reason I like this mission. This door can be picked open. Inside is an armory of sorts. You can find a gas mine, 3 flash bombs, and 2 fire arrows in there. In addition, let me show you something weird. I don't have the key anymore. Because I returned it. But the key from the archer at the very beginning of the mission can unlock and lock the door. Weird. We have found the opera house. We've got that objective checked, so awesome. Wait for this guy to get out of the way. Let's move back here again. We move through here, we're in the pool chambers. If you want to jump into the pool itself, you can find 2 water arrows, if you're so inclined. Let's just keep on going. Plenty of shadows to hide in. That's the way we like it. You move up here to the left, the archway on the left, we get to the wine cellar. Now, one servant patrols the wine cellar in a counterclockwise circle, so I'm just... He must be on the other side right now because I haven't seen him. What he doesn't do is come into this intersection. You see there are 5 rooms with, or down here. What we want to do is head into the far left. There's not much going on. You have to be careful because you have to jump to reach it, but, well, not yet. This one in the middle hole of the lower rack. Good bottle of wine, worth 50, total 100. It's the only one in the whole room. So you can leave. The next 3 all lead to this same little system of tunnels, whatever you want to call them. Head left back here. Find another bottle of wine, worth 50. Brings our total to 150. Okay, I hear the servant now. He just passed by. Head into the rightmost entrance. In this one, the middle hole on the top rack has our valuable wine worth 200. There's one more bottle in here. Head up the left ramp. That way you're following the servant and you won't run headlong into him. Head counterclockwise through this little system. And here in this alcove, next to the crate, you can find one more bottle of wine. Still worth 50, brings our total to 250. That's it. So now, back out in the main basement hallway. Move quickly through here while the coast is clear. Now we're heading into the food zone.
What's that?
This is the way up we want to use. Let's get into this shadow. Wait for homeboy. So you can see, one of our three secret passages is here in the middle room. Turns out it's in the fireplace. That's the way we're gonna get to the first floor. So we will just follow the servant right into here. Cook, remember to serve the ballerinas only a light supper the night of a performance, lest we have a repeat of little Catherine's unwelcome addition to Thursday night's show. Consider this your first and only warning. Mr. Cribbs, Director of Music. And we arrive at the first floor. Always worth a real save. Let's drop down on the east side first.
So, did you read Cribb's latest? That gibberish is a waste of my art.
Ironic, since I always considered your art to be a waste.
And, to add injury to insult, I'm forced to wear costumes from years past.
I can't believe the Opera House is still losing money. It's all these lower-class people working in the ticket office and such. They steal whatever they can get their hands on. Valerius should fire all of them.
For once, I agree with you, Christine. Scrapping the lower class would certainly clean things up around here. But what will you do for food and shelter when they kick you out?
Taffer.
So, the performers aren't nice people either, turns out. Anyway, just stick to the shadows. And I forgot which table it was on. And it's very easy to sneak over to this table and grab a tiara. Worth 125, brings our total to 375. Now, we don't want to go out that door because the dude is staring right at it, so head back in here. Close that behind us and head to the other side of this secret passage. Garrett can get under here. He just, you know, he gets confused, bless his heart. Forgets how to crouch down. So, you can hear a patroller here. He's got a key I want to pickpocket. And then we can drop it back on the carpet on his route. No problem. That's two pickpockets. So just creep across the tile as you follow the patroller. Pretty straightforward, although I almost made a big mistake there. Got another shadow to hide in here. Head into the kitchen. Quieter than that, if possible. Okay, we gotta move fast. The guard's gonna get to us. Alright, in this room, next to the cook, we can find two gold goblets, 25 each, and two gold plates, 50 each. Brings our total to 525. I was worried about that guy. His route covers the entire opera house, as near as I can tell. I've never taken the time to completely track his patrol route because it's huge, but Well, I don't know how I'm gonna solve this problem. If that guy's nearby, I'm just gonna need to move quickly and get back to my shadow. Not good enough. Maybe if I head left to that shadow, I'll be able to wait for him to get past me wherever he's going. Let's see if I can get out there now.
There.
Well, let's not take an unnecessary first alert. Whoops. The other thing I already forgot is that the servant was pretty glued to that wall, so if I moved to this one, I should be in a good spot to wait. Guard gets by, no problem. Servant gets by, no problem. Alright, I'm gonna wait for the guard to pass by again because I want to head down that hall and head into the main stage. Always be careful to move nice and slow across the tile floor, because, you know, Garrett's got his tap shoes on. Okay, we're good. Alright, so, inch left onto the main stage area. And you see where we are. Let's try and avoid that first alert, because I don't think we have to take it. Excellent. All right. If we just creep through this area down in front and stay off the actual stage for now. It's not too tough to avoid being spotted by any of those people up in the audience. For now, we just want to get across the room to the hallway on the other side. Mm-hmm. I guess I should mention that I took a couple of Supreme busts I didn't have to down in the caverns. Namely, I think it is possible to get by all the Kraymen without any first alerts, but you can't actually Supreme the mission. And I was too worried anyway. At least I think you can't Supreme the mission. Yeah. I guess you can without perfect thiefing it, but you know me, I'm too much of a klepto to skip loot, as it turns out. I'll slip into this hallway, same way we did at the start. Now that we're across, if we wait here, we'll encounter another patroller, and he'll have another pickpocket for us. Well, maybe we don't need to wait. You never know how the timing is gonna be. This dark corner is safe to hide in. Garrett is not cooperating with the creeping today. I wonder if something's wrong with my shift key. Anyway, we want to pick his pocket, but it might be easier to do if we wait down there. Let's find out. Now that room there is the barracks. I'm going to skip it because all that's in there is equipment. There's no loot. It's possible to move through that room and get everything with nothing but first alerts. Inside, you can find two guards, as well as two gas arrows, a healing potion, six broadhead arrows, and a speed potion. But none of that matters to me. So I don't think Garrett really feels like staying quiet on the tile, so let's see if I can fix my controls. Little save load lovin'. If you ever find your controls not quite working, saving and loading like that can really help. Fixes a lot of problems. I want to get to this carpet so I can run down and get that key before he's gone. Very good. Alright. There's our third pickpocket. We can just leave that on his patrol route. This unlocked door has some loot for us. How do you like that? Three plates worth 50 each. And a vase also worth 50. Bring our loot total to 725. Now, wait for him to pass by heading east. And head into the ticket office. Ah, tile floor, goody! It's just such an unfortunate fact of life by this point, I don't even really register it. Now the good news is, he will never turn unless we make noise and get him searching for us. So, we do have to be careful though, because the middle two booths, we can be seen by the guy you hear patrolling out there. So, here in this safe closest to us, which is unlocked, find the cash box with a paltry 25 gold coins in it. Is that it? Yes. But we've ticked that objective. Brings our total to 750. Now we have to silently get out of here. Which is not too hard to do, but still don't want to mess it up. I think I figured out what breaks my controls. Just make sure you let go of the shift key when you hit quick load. Otherwise, it won't register when you're pressing it, and creeping becomes almost impossible. There we go. Now we just silently drop down onto more tile. Well, that wasn't silent, but didn't even get a first alert from anyone, so I guess we're okay. Now we need to follow this swordsman. Alright. We're coming up on some fancy stuff. And a spot where we are, unfortunately, gonna have to use a moss arrow. Not something I like to do, a supreme bust, but, you know, it is what it is. Wait for him to turn around and we'll follow him. Be careful of that girl off in the distance. The good news is the edge of the room is carpeted, so you can move quickly. The space behind this statue's really the only good hiding spot in this room. Note the tiara on the statue's head. Worth 125 brings our total to 875. There are two water arrows in the fountain if you're interested. Now, let's move south. It's time to deal with her. She's got a piece of loot I want. So, get around the corner of this third room into these handy shadows. And get across the room that way.
Is someone over there? Oh well, sorry. Guess it was nothing.
Oh. Now, you can't avoid a first alert from her right there. Which is unfortunate. There's a purse in the, I guess it's the coat check room right behind her. I'm gonna make sure this shadow's safe from the guard before I quick save. It is. Good. As we... let's creep out into the hallway.
Is that you, Kevil?
On another first alert. Now what we have to do here...
Sorry, nothing here now. What was that there? I saw some... I surrender!
Believe it or not, it's possible to just jump through there...
Is that you, Kevil?
...and not get anything but a first alert.
I don't know what that was.
And wait for him to turn around again.
What's that?
Hmm. Nothing but a first alert. So there's the purse, worth 100 loot, total 975. Now, we can't get back out the way we came. Unfortunate, I know. But it is what it is. Now, there's a secret passage back here. But at the top, you have to either slash or transmigrate through a banner. And the issue, of course, is that you bust your ghost, period, if you slash the banner. And as far as transmigration, that's only as a last resort, and there are other ways around this girl. So, I'm going to wait until I hear the swordsman leave again.
What was that there? I saw something. Sorry, nothing here now.
Gotta go this way.
Oh, is someone over there? Glad it was nothing.
I think, hopefully, I'm out of sight of the patroller. I think I am. Now, here's where we have to moss the floor. Reason being that our way back is to jump into the shadow we used in the first place.
Is that you, Kevil?
No good. Try again.
What was that? Please, don't... I don't have any money. Is someone over there?
Done. Good.
Oh well, too many imaginings. What was that there? I saw something. What's
nope.
That? Hey, it...
Oh, Garrett. Oh, Garrett. Please just creep.
Someone there?
Nope. No one here, sweetheart. Move along. All right. Now with that handled...
Glad it was nothing.
Time to head upstairs. That was fancy, huh? Swing right. Get into this door. Come on, Garrett. There you go. All right. That's the first floor. Wait until we have some breathing room here. The best way to move on these stairs is to stay at the edge, because the floor is wooden and it's pretty dark unless you're standing right over one of those lights. Oh. We want to leave through that doorway, but we do have to be careful, because in addition to the patroller, there are a couple of stationary guards up at the top of that second set of stairs heading up to the third floor, who can spot us if they're turned the wrong way. I don't want that. I don't think they bust our ghost, though. Oh, but there's the turn anyway. I'll take the first alert. I don't care that much. So through here, we can get to our talisman, actually. Nobody patrols this hallway, so you just have to take care to be quiet. That's not where I wanted to go. That's not what I was looking for either. I've become disoriented. Okay, here I am on the second floor. Need to get to that rotunda in the south. This is what I want. Okay. Can't get over how much I love the ambient noise in this mission. The orchestra tuning, I think it's just brilliant. Yeah, this is what I want. Good. Let's go ahead and hit the secret passage. It's over here. If we open that bad boy up. Hope Garrett can figure out how to get through it. My controls are broken again, sorry.
Ah, a hidden entrance.
Indeed. Now up at the top here is what we need Raul's key for. Can't open that lock without it. So here inside Valerius's office, as long as you have not tripped any alarms, the office will be empty and you can move around in it freely. We're going to need this blue key to get our talisman. There is the talisman of water. So let's close the chest and relock it. Let's put the key back. I remain convinced it's possible. Come on, Garrett. I believe in you. Well, I think that's as close as I'm gonna get. Alright. Good enough, good enough. Let's read the scroll. We're gonna need this yellow key. We'll have to bring it back later, too. My most enchanting Lady V, I will cherish the flute always. Its outward beauty is matched only by its glorious tone. I must endeavor to keep it safe. However, I will be somewhat indisposed at home until this confounded furuncle heals. I hope I do not impose too much upon you, but will you look after this key to my wall safe while I recover? The flute is there, of course. I hope to return to my duties as music director before the new moon. Your friend and colleague, Ian Cribbs. Put that back. This box has a ring in it, worth 100, brings our total to 1,075. And of course, we've got the Talisman of Water. So, good news all around. That's it for now, so let's lock this back behind us. Although we will be back later to return the yellow key. Let's open this bad boy up. Get all the way back out to the big central staircase. My creep controls are broken. Gotta be careful of that. So now, back at the big central staircase, We want to wait for the patroller to go by, and then we want to follow him. So let's do that. Not going to worry too much about first alerts from those guys. As long as they don't go search mode.
All quiet now. Must have been rats.
Down the stairs we go. Alright. Well, this is familiar territory. We want to move south through here. And then time for us to actually get on the stage. Best place to do that is between these two spotlights. All without even tripping a first alert. Pretty good, pretty good. All right, here we are on stage. Now this big central room has a total of four people, you know, in and around it. They're not too hard to handle, but we want to go through that doorway on the south wall. We have an opening.
Just as you cleared. If there's any trouble, we double the guard on Lady Valerius's rooms.
Not the ticket office. Cause if I were a thief, that's where I'd go.
But seeing as you're a guard and not a thief, you're clear on where to go if there's trouble?
If there's trouble, someone needs to guard the cloak check girl. She's all alone with no one to talk to.
When you're a captain, choose to guard whatever you like. Until then, let's hear it. Where do you go if there's trouble?
Yeah, to guard that watery stone nobody cares about, except than Lady Valerius.
Good. When you're done moping, I suggest you get on with your patrol.
I rather like that conversation. Let's read this right quick. Carmella, a stellar performance as usual. I ride in hopes that you will consent to a stroll this evening on the second floor promenade. I promise I will not arrive empty-handed. Please do not refuse me. I will wait all night if need be. A short stroll and some pleasant conversation is all I ask, and in return I have for you a most special gift, one fit for a queen. Awaiting you on the promenade, I remain your most ardent admirer, Lord B. Oh, good. We get to rob Lord Bafford again. How much fun is that? Okay. I'm going to wait for this patroller to get wherever he's going. Now, we have to use this ladder to get to the second floor. Not that tough, but just be careful of everybody. Just need to make that mantle without anyone spotting you. Now, up here on the second floor, these doors can both be picked. They lead to the same storage room, so it doesn't really matter which one you take. In this storage room, you can find 2 gold candlesticks worth 50 each, total 1175. And where's the other bit? Is it over here? And there you go. One of those lost city tapestries. Brings our worth 100, worth 200, I think. Yeah, full 200. Which brings our total to 1325. With that done, quietly head back out. Through this door at the end is the 4th pickpocket, which we do want.
Is someone there?
I don't particularly care about
Seems
a first
quiet
alert.
Enough now. Oh well.
As long as he stays turned.
Who goes there? Oh well.
That was too close.
It was nothing. Hello? Show yourself.
Okay. Yeah.
Nothing here now.
He does turn. I forgot about that. I wonder. I wonder if this key can relock the.
Who's the intruder?
Storeroom. Need to check on that. As soon as he gives me enough
Hello?
Time.
Show yourself.
I think it can. Nope, it can't. Okay. Now let's get his key as close to him as we can.
When are they going? What's there?
Go on and turn, Broseph. Nothing to see here. Okay. Good enough. So, back down the ladder, same way we got up. And just get through the room to the north. Plenty of shadows to hide in, just be aware of all the different guards. Maybe he had a pickpocket, but he doesn't. There he is. That's the pickpocket I'm wondering about. This one is our 5th pickpocket, for those keeping track. Thought dropping it there would be safe, and it was. Most excellent. Now, both of these doors are unlocked, so let's just bust into one. Shut it behind us. There are 2 vases in here, worth 100 each. Thought there was one on this side. Must be wrong. Yeah, Yeah, they're both over here. Okay. There's one, there's the other. Brings our total to 1525. Back out to backstage yet again. Up this ladder. And get up here the same way we did on the other side. Just do the mid-air mantle. This door here is Cribs' office. We have to pick it open, and we can't relock it. Now, a conversation is going to start in here, and we want to finish all our business before it's over, so...
But wait! Who is this I spy? Who does...
Oh, my creep control is busted. Hate that.
But wait, who is this I spy? Who does fell wood from my domain?
Come on, really? Again? Okay, let's just jump onto the carpet.
But wait, who is this I spy?
Read this. Mr. Cribs, Ian, dearest, these are great times for thinkers such as ourselves. I am certain that the secrets of the artifact will soon be mine. With its powers and the power unleashed by your music, I am more and more convinced that our day is near. Please accept this flute as a token of my continued appreciation. Appreciation for our special friendship and for your tireless dedication to the opera. Yours always, Lady Valerius. Open the safe with the key.
That's good.
This will make a nice little bonus.
Grab the flute. Worth 100 brings our total to 1675. Relock the safe. And creep out.
Wait, who is this I spy? Who dares fell?
No, no! With gusto, and emphasize the word dares, like this.
Who dares fell wood for my domain?
I've got a better idea. Why don't you sing the part of Conandra Forest Princess tomorrow night? And while you're at it, why don't you find yourself another leading lady?
Maybe I will.
Fine. Untalented taffer troglodyte.
Me, 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 me.
And with that done, of course, our flute objective is done. Wait until the coast is clear, head on back down.
You'll be full of holes soon!
Oh. All right. Well, I was about to say he's the one I'm not aware of. There he is. I figured out where he was. Oh, let's read this. Captain Collyard and men of the Opera Guard, two guards will at all times, day and night, be posted outside my office suite. In case of trouble or commotion of any kind in the Opera House, then send two more to stand guard directly inside the suite. The artifact must be protected. I will tolerate no lapses in security. L. Valerius. Well, too bad for her. She didn't find out about the secret passages before stealing the Opera House from our buddy Raoul. All right. Now we need to get back down off the stage.
I thought I saw something.
I don't particularly care about first alerts, so I'm gonna take that. From here, just heading back to the central staircase. and fix my creep control again. Back to the central stairs. Back in real darkness. And take a real save. Alright. Now, before you get all the way upstairs, get out your rope arrows. Fire one off right there. Peek next to this statue. Grab the gold nugget. Worth 100. Brings our total to 1775. And get back to the wood paneling on the side. Wait for homeboy to get past us. Get through the same door as before. Look at that. Servant who goes everywhere, and he's coming this way. Holy crap. Okay, let's... that was a near miss. Holy cow. Did that door just disappear?
Did you know?
I think the door just disappeared. How annoying. Well, I guess it doesn't matter much. I guess I'm gonna wait for the servant to go by. And I'll try to rescue the door. I like having doors. Alright. One more try, but I don't care much. All right. Saved the door. Very good. Now he's going to come back the same way, I think. All right. Kept the door. Perfect. Who am I hearing? All these doors disappear. Head back out this way. Move over here to the left. Another patroller's gonna come through here, and he's got a speed potion we want. So, Wait until I spot him. I hear him coming now. Drop that back on his patrol route and just stick with him. Through the better part of this room. Get over to the star. Hit that switch in the center of it. Then hustle across to this secret door.
I thought I saw something.
Probably have to take that first alert.
Thought I saw something.
The rats around here before.
Come on, Garrett. Ugh. Broken creep controls are the worst.
See things. I'd better get some rest.
All right, good. Whew. Guess we just shut it manually. So in here, we find a little study. We've got one of those Lost City rug thingamajiggers. 1925. Two candlesticks, 50 each, brings our total to 2025, which solves our loot objective. Let's read. I am beginning to suspect that I do not have revenge in my blood, for if I did, I would go now and steal from Lady Valerius all the contents of her office suite. She doesn't know about the secret passageway that leads there from the second floor rotunda. She doesn't know about the key that works the lock. When she took over here and dismissed my whole staff, all knowledge of the secret passages and rooms left with us. I return here now and then to obtain provisions, always with the thought of exacting some revenge, but I fear I carry with me a terrible flaw. I do not have revenge in my blood. Raoul. Okay. Very good. We have to time the guard here, but the good news, of course, is that we don't have to get to the star this time. We can just manually shut the door behind us. I'm going to wait until... Wait until the guard passes by heading the other way, I think. Do a quick save load just to make sure my creep controls are fixed. That speed potion, by the way, was the 6th pickpocket, for those who are keeping track. 6 out of 13. We are nearing the end, though, friends, and the hardest stuff is over. I mean, if we were going for Supreme, it'd be a lot more difficult, but we can't Supreme this mission and get all the loot at the same time, so... Not gonna worry too much about it. I'm gonna shut that behind me.
What's up?
I thought I saw something.
I'm starting to see things. I'd better get some rest.
Busted on over to the shadows in this room. Wait for that guard to turn around and leave again. Where Garrett just doesn't want to creep this time. This whole mission. Well, these guys are... they're weirding me out. Who else am I hearing? Anyway, let's head through this door the servant used, and let's try and keep it from, you know, vanishing on us. In the middle of these three connected rooms are two goblets, 25 each, brings our total to 2,075. If we can head back out through the same door. Make sure the door still exists. Head back to the rotunda with the secret passage. First thing I'll do is head back upstairs and replace Cribs's yellow key on Valerius's desk. Right where we found it. Now, as far as returning things go, all we have that we can return, and we will end up returning it, is Raoul's key. So now, I should have done this earlier, let's loot the rotunda itself. Here in the back are three plates. Worth 50 each, brings our total to 2225. And over in the front are three purple goblets, which bring our total to 2270. You can do this jumping, it's easier than creeping. Just make sure you actually land on the carpet. See that archer up there? Just wait and follow him. Up here we can finally get into the opera boxes where we saw people standing every time we were down in or on or around the main stage. So take this first opening. You can pickpocket this woman's opera glasses. That's our seventh pickpocket. Brings our loot total to 2320. That box is empty. Are you kidding me? They're never kidding. Never kidding, are they? From here, I think I'll just wait for the archer to come back and follow him again. Anyway, like I said, 7th pickpocket, loot total 2320. I guess I should mention this too. This is the last mission that features standard, normal human guards, so enjoy it. We have some Hammerites, but...
This from Valerius and Cribs is a testament to the superiority of human intellect. Man overcomes nature. Oh, my absolute favorite theme.
I couldn't disagree with you more. This opera is more of a travesty than a testament. The only thing overcome were my poor ears by that horrendous music Cribs has written.
You're just miffed because Cribs is fond of tragic endings.
That's not it at all. Since Valerius took over, we've had to endure this Mr. Cribs and his twisted little operettas with Vines and Lycas as villains and other complete nonsense. How can you stand it?
Well, I say in with the new. That's what I say.
Lean forward, grab his purse. Shouldn't really be a problem. That's our 8th pickpocket, brings our loot total to 2420. This time I think I'll wait for the archer to be heading that way. Sneak in behind him. Let's make sure I'm in the shadows. Let's bust on down to this last opening.
The rats around here perform more than we do.
She has the... That was only a first alert. She has our 9th pickpocket. Another set of opera glasses brings our loot total to 2470. I'll wait for him to head back south. And squeak out here.
I thought I saw something. These halls must speak from the past.
There is, I thought, a patroller in here. Maybe I'm just confused. I think I see his sword down there, though. Get into a shadow and save. Try and figure out what's what. He's down there. Oh, there he goes. Okay. His patrol was, distance locked. I've mentioned that before. I think I've even been able to show it to you before, but there's another example of how the Dark Engine, in order to, you know, conserve processor power, memory, whatever, if you're far enough away from a patroller, it'll freeze him in place until you get close enough to reactivate him. Makes for some unpredictable behavior on the part of many of our AIs. Now that he's patrolling again, we'll follow him back out to the main staircase again, complete with our two buddies.
Nothing to be seen now.
Keep first alerting like bosses, as long as that's all they do, I'm cool with it. Squeeze in behind this vase. We've seen him before. We picked a speed potion off of him. But now, coming in from this side, we want to get up behind that woman and get her opera glasses. We're going to have to take a first alert to do it, unfortunately. But if we hold it to the edge of the room...
Huh? Who's there?
Oops.
Thought I saw something.
You saw nothing. The problem is this chair. We have to squeak around. We can do it with only a first alert. Then as we creep ever so cautiously closer to these two, eventually I know I can lean forward and reach them without triggering a search alert. That was our 10th pickpocket, which brings our loot total to 2520. The most dangerous part of this is getting around this chair.
Is someone there? Guess it was nothing.
There we go. Darkness.
Guess it was nothing.
That's right, bro. Nothing. Absolutely nothing to see here. Let's get back out of this room. Get back behind that vase. In the shadow, on the wood floor, that's a good place to be parked and saved. So, let's do it. Ba-doom! Alright. Wait for all this traffic to clear out. Get back into this hallway. Now, need to worry about this patroller too. Let's get into one of the shadows. So we need to get around on the other side of him. Oh, we let him pass by. Here is the promenade where the one and only Lord Bafford is hanging out. Now, I wonder if I can get around the corner with just a first alert.
What's that in the shadow there?
Huh?
Yes, I
can. Never mind. There's no one here.
The rats around here perform more than we do.
That's the 11th pickpocket.
What was that?
Brings our loot total to 2720.
These halls must speak from the past.
11th pickpocket. Oh my gosh, shut up. Alright.
La 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 la. Huh? The rats around here perform more than we do.
I'll talk to you as soon as I get to some actual quiet. Alright, tag along with this swordsman. Anyway, that necklace, worth 200, was our 11th pickpocket, brought our total to 2720, and it brings with it the sentimental gratification of having robbed Lord Baffert once again. Squeeze into this hall on the left. Ugh. My creep controls were disabled once again. Keeps happening. I don't understand why, and I don't like it. But no matter, they're working now. Get into a shadow. And quick save. Get around this corner. This door doesn't have a key that corresponds to it, but we can pick it open. Takes us into the library on our map. Here in the library, I know the stairs are metal, but no one can hear you. And we arrive at the third floor. I haven't real saved in a long time. It'd be good to do it now, I think. Up here on the third floor, there's some reading material. Reginald and Canandra, Forest Princes, or The Tragical Tale of Forbidden Devotion Betwixt Our Hero Reginald, Hammerite Novice, and the Sprightly Canandra, Forest Denizen and Ruler of All Trees. Libretto and Music by Ian Cribbs. Act 1, The Forest Edge. Reginald has been sent to cut wood. He sings, "I am but a simple novice, sent here to bring wood from forest. Happy is this sunny day, if only it could stay this way." Canandra, singing from afar, "Ah, glorious sun, send your rays upon us. But wait, who is this I spy? Who dares fell wood from my domain? He will learn the folly of his ways." Canandra lands a blow upon Reginald's head. Reginald sings, "Ah, pound me not, foul forest thing." He raises his axe in a defensive stance. Reginald sees Canandra for the first time. He sings, "Did I say, foul forest thing? For thou art beautiful as a butterfly's wing." Canandra, her eyes meeting Reginald's, sings, "Didst I land a blow upon your head? For I would rather take my own life instead." They embrace, they exit stage left, the forest creatures sing, "Na na na, la la la, etc." End Act 1.
Did people really pay money to see this stuff?
And that you can't actually read, even though it looks like you should be able to. So, have to pick this door too. Now, there are... The third floor's tough. There are the two stationary guards at the top of the main stairs. At the primary door into Lady Valerius's office, there are two more. And there are two patrollers. You can see one of them over there has been distance locked. So, that's fine. I guess I don't have to worry about him for now. Oh, there he's moving. Not enough to trigger his animation yet, but close enough for him to start moving. Over here, there's a vase worth 50, brings our total to 2770. Out here is another opera box. He has a purse. That's our 12th pickpocket, brings our loot total to 2870. There's another patroller. I think we squeaked into the shadows with no real trouble. Well, this is a trouble patch. We have to get through this area without getting spotted by anyone. But turns out we get pretty darn lucky with the way everyone's facing and the timing of the patrols. That was actually pretty easy. So I'm gonna wait for this guy to head back to the north again. Might take a little bit, but I don't care. There are only a couple of things left to do. There's one pickpocket left. It's on that archer you've seen at the end of the hall. And there's one piece of loot left, too. After that, all that's left is to get out and replace Raoul's key. See our archer friend there. So through here, in this spectator box, is the last piece of loot. Another set of opera glasses. Worth 50. Brings our total to 2920. Couple of first alerts. Whatever. The very last thing is to get the healing potion. Off of the archer that walks out here. That's not actually a shadow. Damn.
Hey, what was that?
Hey! It's cut!
So, I think the best way to do this is to jump out to the red carpet and grab the potion when we see the archer. Okay, I hear him coming. Can't jump too soon. So wait a little bit. Lean out, grab his potion. There's our 13th pickpocket, so if we drop it on his route. We're set to leave. 13 out of 13 pickpockets, 2920 out of 2920 loot. One last thing remains, even though I'm not supreme ghosting in terms of first alerts, I can leave everything like it was. I'm gonna return Raoul's key and get out through the basement. So, let's creep crouch by these guys again. Hopefully we get as lucky as we did last time.
Hello?
What was that?
Show yourself.
Did you see it?
All quiet now. Must have been rats.
Just first alerts, which are fine with me. Head across another tile floor patch. Head up to the library. Oh, disappearing doors. Don't want that. It may be a dark engine glitch, but all the same, I do think the Opera House would notice if the doors were just gone, even more than they would if they were open, so. Squeak through there, close the door behind us, very good. Back down the stairs. To the second floor. Roll on out here. Oh, can't have that. Actually, let's go the other way.
Hey, I think I saw something.
There we go. Okay. There's the sword, other patroller, so just wait for him to go by. All the way down to the stage door. Close that bad boy behind us. Oh no, another disappearing door at the very end. I'd like to avoid that if possible. So, let's just squeeze into the doorway and wait for the guard to leave. Should be okay. Yes, very good. Alright, close the door behind us, through the fireplace, back down the ladder into the basement. Gotta be wary of the dude out there. Not really any good way to tell where he is. He heard us land. Still heard us land. I hate ladders. I really do. Okay, we're good. Let's wait for him to pass by going the other way. Then pop out behind him. Sneak across the basement. No problem here. back into the sewers. Back to Raoul.
Treasure from the old keeper's shrine, but evil, evil lady, why, oh, why did you take everything that was mine?
Give his key back to him. And then exiting is a simple matter, of turning right in this sewer and going out the manhole. I would like to close the manhole behind me. One last step. If Garrett can climb the ladder, be much better. Perfect. Alright, there it is. Perfect Thief in Song of the Caverns. Way, way the hell off of Supreme, I mean. A veritable myriad of first alerts while we were playing that mission. And in addition to get the purse behind the coat check lady, I had to use one moss arrow. So there are, those are the Supreme busts. I mean, I can hardly keep track of all the first alerts. There were some from the audience in front of the stage. There were some from the guests in the second floor area with the secret star button. There were more from them when I went in to get their purses. There were more from the audience when I was sneaking around behind the stage, picking their pockets. Plenty of first alerts from the guys at the top of the main central staircase. First alerts from the Craymen and the Spider in the cavern section at the very beginning. Tons and tons of first alerts, that's the bottom line. But, like I said, ghost intact, perfect thief achieved because we have 2920 loot out of 2920, 13 out of 13 pickpockets in 1 hour, 44 minutes, and 37 seconds. We picked 4 locks, we have 0 backstabs and knockouts, no damage dealt or taken, no healing taken, nothing and nobody killed. For the campaign so far, 26 hours, 31 minutes, 11 seconds total time, 25,266 loot so far, total damage dealt 20, the training mission, and received 0. Believe it or not, this number will go up some more before the end of the game. It'll go up in Return to the Cathedral, where an objective requires us to kill some bad guys. But that's it. I hope you enjoyed Song of the Caverns. I will see you in Undercover next time. Until then, have a great day. Bye-bye.